This is roll for sanity.
Because yeah. Fate comes from Fudge, and Fudge, mm-hmm. I downloaded that from the interweb when the interweb was like brand new. Days.
I remember that first came out, yeah.
Mm-hmm. It was Fudge 0.9 or something like that.
I remember.
And it was free. It was free. It was, and yeah, I tried to read free. It, and I'm like, I thought this was a game. It's not a game. It's a toolkit to make a right, role-playing a game. Game from.
Right.
And the guys at Evil Hat or whoever made Fate from that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
so and this like, is okay. That's kinda, one guy who made a rule book from Fudge. You know, that's how
right.
That's how easy Fudge is easy to understand.
Well, that's what I'm kind of going for with Dig RPG Core is like yeah. it's a framework to make a setting, which the setting is actually the game because
the settings is the game.
Yeah, they can be cross compatible because of the resolution, but like they could be very different.
I mean, like how D&D. You mean how D&D is the game and the setting?
Well, D&D is... Well,
or Classic Traveler is the like, game and the setting?
Yeah, like 5th edition is like the game and like... let's be nice and say 2/3 of the setting. Like, they leave out big chunks. It's almost like they didn't want to touch deities with a 10-foot pole at the time. So they just said, here's some deities from history. And then they just kind of like forgot that, you know, religion actually existed in their game. And then, you know, they turned the page. It just like, I don't know. But that's what I made a campaign setting for 5th edition too. And that's what it came out of was there's holes and I got to fill the holes. And I filled the holes, which is what every guy that plays RPGs wants to do, but doesn't know how to do. So I filled them for them.
Yeah. When I was 14 trying to play Traveler, I was like, there's holes in these rules. I mean,
yeah,
I'm not experienced enough to make up mm-hmm. a rule or what do you do when the characters are doing this? Cause there's no rule for it in the book.
Right? Well, that's what's really strange about, I would say supplements for any of these games is that they're actually for new people. They're not for like really intermediate advanced people because they'll make up their own stuff.
You're right.
Like they don't need it.
For Traveler Second Edition, I own 2 books.
Right. For any other like academic subject or something like that, the books are for the people that are drilling down. Like, you know, They gotta learn more about, you know, what the secret sauce is so that they can put it together yeah. and, you know, convince somebody that actually does grants and stuff that they know what they're talking about or at least more than they do so that they can get the money to do the thing that is kind of science, but not really the next 10 years.
To be certified, you have to know all the things. It's,
yeah.
Especially
I was there at 15 with Traveler, you know, I thought it was, oh, this is cool. And I got all the subsystems. Mm-hmm. So, you know, the character generation, the ship combat, the trade system. It's like, but how do I put all this together to play games with
yeah. people? It's hard. Yeah. Well, it's almost like a
toolkit. The first right. edition. Well,
it's like, it is.
It's like Genesis system as well. It's okay. Like they've got all of this Star Wars stuff, but in terms of like actually having any way for people to play, like to have like an adventure module or something like that. Nope, because I think what they understand is that those adventure modules are a waste of time. Like they don't sell. But it's like, so it's basically like it's a Pandora's black box that isn't open, and it's like huh. You know, there's no Pandora yet. And
that's one way to think of it.
And it's like the people that figure it out, and the people that don't, they just buy another book. They buy somebody else's book, and they just look at them on shelves.
Buying a Genesis game is like buying a video game that you can't really mod.
It's like, so Genesis, GENESYS, the Fantasy Flight Star Wars system.
Yeah.
I'll tell you, it's one of the coolest systems I've ever played with a virtual tabletop. Trying to play it in reality and trying to like match up the dice that cancel themselves out and stuff.
Yeah, the app nightmare. Cancels out the dice for you, right?
Yeah, yeah. But I didn't know there was an app, but I played with virtual tabletop. But yeah, it just shows you like what's the result in terms of like the symbols, and that was very helpful. But yeah, it gives you like I've seen a few like fan adventures that have been written, And that's actually what I use because I did a couple of professional sessions with it.